to Reaching Out. I'm your host, Kim Carey. And today we have guests from Ekankar, Cyan Hughes, who is the Regional Seminar Coordinator, and Nicole Kletzka, who is the Youth and Family Services Director. Welcome both of you Reaching Out. Very, very good to see you and meet you. And I'm going to start with you, Nicole. What is Ekankar?
Ekankar is the religion of the light and sound of God. Mm-hmm. And it is a spiritual path that individuals follow to help us refine ourselves and come closer to an understanding of God. The word Ekankar actually means total awareness or co-worker with God. Mm-hmm. And in Ekankar, our job is really to evolve and to become more spiritual, to learn more love, and ultimately to become co-workers with God.
Your voice is so calming. So calming. I feel that vibration coming from you. Totally. Okay. Well, Cyan, tell us, what are some of the beliefs of Ekankar?
Sure. Some of the beliefs of Ekankar, soul, we are soul. We don't have souls, we are soul, and soul exists because God loves it. Yes. We believe in reincarnation, karma, soul travel, and dreams. Mm-hmm. And we are here to gain experience, to develop spiritually, and become one of God.
You are very unique because you have been affiliated with Ekankar for 33 years, all of your life. What has that meant to you?
Well, it's meant quite a bit to me, actually. Growing up in Ekankar has been a treat, but much different than what you may anticipate. It's kind of given me the tools, growing up as a child, to keep me grounded and really understand from an awareness point of view of why certain things in life happen. Mm-hmm. So I've really been able to learn from a young age of the tools that Ekankar provides, from a spiritual point of view, to understand why certain things happen, how I can grow spiritually and gain experiences that I need to gain.
Give me a short example of something that's occurred in your life where you've used the tools that you've learned from Ekankar.
Sure. A particular job I have now, there's always a lot of fires, as many people may say it, a lot of last minute things that you have to accomplish, and a lot of people will panic. But you kind of understand why certain things are happening, why if you went a certain way in your job, or certain something's happening within your life, why something's happening like that. You try to take that experience and learn from it. So, for instance, if I've done something with a job prior to and I've gone through the experience, then I know what to expect next time. I know I'm not going to panic because I understand. Mm-hmm. I took that in and understood and grew from that. Mm-hmm. Where some people you kind of see where they have the same experience over and over again because they're not learning from their same prior mistakes or right. from prior experiences.
Which is good.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes. And you were introduced to Ekankar by your parents.
Yes, I was.
That's wonderful. Which brings me to you, Nicole. You've been affiliated for 28 years. So tell us how you found it. Ekankar.
I actually found Ekankar from my mom as well.
Really?
From my parents.
Okay.
But it was kind of, I was in college. Mm. And I had, during one of the years in school, I got to travel to Europe, and I was by myself traveling. Mm-hmm. So my mom was kind of worried about me. She was like, okay, I just need to make sure you're safe. Yeah. And while I was there, she found out about Ekankar. Mm. And so she'd be on the phone, I'd be talking internationally, and she'd be saying, I have this Ekankar thing that I've learned about. And I'd be like, oh no, mom's doing something crazy here. What is it? Mm-hmm. And then I went to Greece. Mm. And when I was in Greece, I was having a little bit too much fun, and it was too hard to get to the telephone. And I got out of contact a little bit with my mom.
Okay.
And she got really, really worried about me. And she had a dream. And in the dream, I came to her and I said to her, don't worry, mom, I'm okay. But there was something that was weird about the dream, and that was that my hair was cut. Mm. And I'd had long hair before and short hair after.
So what did the cutting of the hair mean?
Well, when I called her the next time, you know, a day or so later, mm-hmm. she said, I knew you were okay because I heard this in a dream, except there was something strange. Your hair was short. Mm-hmm. And I went, oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
She had no idea that I had actually cut my hair.
Wow.
And it was one of those moments, those aha moments.
Yes.
Where I thought, you know what? There's something more here than meets the eye.
That's true.
And then my trip to Europe had many more of those kinds of moments.
Mm-hmm.
And I came back and I started studying Ekinkar.
Mm-hmm.
And I have never looked back.
Wow. That's awesome. Very good. Very good story. Who is the spiritual leader?
The spiritual leader is Sri Harold Klemp.
Mm-hmm.
He is the current living Ek master, and we always have a living Ek master in Ekinkar. It's not someone you worship. It's someone you show great respect for. And the reason that you have a master is that they have a high level of consciousness, and they are in tune with what the consciousness is of the day.
Mm-hmm.
So it can change and grow as society and as we all change. There is also an inner master, and Sri Harold forms both of those roles.
Mm-hmm.
And we call him the Mahanta.
Mm-hmm.
And he is the dream master. He works with us in our inner worlds to help us progress spiritually.
Mm-hmm. Now, how long is he in this position? Does it change over or until he passes to another existence?
Yeah, until he translates.
Transitions. Oh, okay. Okay.
That's death. So
yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So how do you progress spiritually in Ekinkar?
Many ways.
Okay. A lot of the readings right now talk about practice. And for me, it's a very much a spiritual discipline where we do spiritual exercises.
Okay.
And every day we're committed to doing 20 minutes a day to stay disciplined. One of them is a simple singing hue, which is an ancient name for God, and it's a chant you do, and a love song to God.
Mm-hmm.
And so it goes, hue. And so that's one of the exercises.
Mm-hmm.
We also do contemplations, which are different than meditations.
Mm.
They're more, you use your imagination, and it helps you kind of quiet your mind. If you meditate, you're trying to get no thoughts. With contemplation, you have imagination kind of leading you, and then you move into soul travel experiences from there.
Mm.
And there's other disciplines that we do as well. Just they call this one the Friday fast,
mm-hmm.
where every Friday you keep your mind on spirit.
Right.
And all of these together are to help us not forget to be focused on spirit, because I think Sion was talking earlier about how it's so easy to get caught up in all the dramas and all the fires.
Sure.
And the spiritual exercises help you to remember that we are soul and to have a higher perspective.
Right. Wow.
Yeah, and just to kind of touch a base upon that, as Nicole mentioned, there are many different techniques and uses that we could develop spiritually. But, you know, we're trying to become whole, and we're trying to become divine love with each other. And so we use different techniques, but also it's just everyday awareness, everyday life, trying to become aware of everything and really trying to develop yourself spiritually to become that person, become one with God, where you can start loving each other and be one soul with each other.
Very good. Now, I know that it's important how you start your day, and if you profess positivity, you project it, then you will draw that. So if you start off negative in the day, you will draw negative experiences, negative people, etc. But even if you start off from a positive plane and you interact with negativity, how do you combat that with Ekinkar, the tools?
Very, very good question. That's kind of part of being a co-worker with God. You're portraying positive vibrations, and you're trying to portray the love to everyone and calm everyone else down.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of just kind of being there helps out other people, soothes them. I get that all the time. You're so calming to be around.
Mm-hmm.
In my head, I'm not always so calm, but I'm portraying that.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of it has to do with that. And like I said, just going through the experiences, understanding why things are happening and going that way. You can teach people if they're willing to listen, but we try not to force that upon people. It's all open, but basically just kind of presenting positive vibrations when you're in a room and trying to do what you can to keep the vibrations neutral and up the mood and whatnot.
And it does. It does change things. So, Nicole, how does someone get involved with Ekankar?
Anyone can come to any of the activities that we have. You don't have to be a member. Mm-hmm. We have several different locations in Michigan, and someone can come to a worship service or a book discussion. We have Hue Chants, which are open to the public as well, where we get together as a group, and it's non-denominational. It doesn't matter. Mm-hmm. Whatever your church, whatever other beliefs you have, you can come. Mm-hmm. And we sing Hue for 20 minutes. Mm. And then if people decide that they want to become more involved and want to join, you can become a member. And membership, they have a donation they ask for that's $60. And it is a donation.
Okay.
And what comes with membership...
Is that yearly?
It's yearly.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And what comes with membership is that they give you these discourses, and they are monthly studies or readings that you do. Mm-hmm. And you do one a month, and they're meant to kind of help you not get too much information, not get too little, mm-hmm. but to move along at a really nice pace. Mm-hmm. And there are also study groups that we have called satsangs. Mm. And you can join with some other ekas and study the discourses, which is wonderful.
Very, very nice. So, Sion, what upcoming events do you have?
We have what's called the Regional Seminar, which has taken place in Troy at the Met Hotel on Crooks. That has taken place May 17th, beginning at 10 a.m. Mm-hmm. And it's open to the public. Non-ECIS members, they are able to attend, and it doesn't cost anything. Mm-hmm. Then you don't have to stay the whole day if you just want to check out certain certain classes, or not classes,
workshops,
thank you.
Okay.
And events. They're more than welcome to come and go as they please. But some people tend to, once they get there, they enjoy the vibrations and enjoy the company and want to learn more and get more out of it. But as I mentioned, it's free to the public if they want to check it out.
Wonderful.
And that occurs every year, but this year is going to be May 17th in Troy.
Wonderful. And so you'll have literature for anyone to take with them.
All right. And we have a website. So if mm-hmm. anyone wants to Google us.
Okay, and that is?
It's www.eck-mi.org.
Right, okay. Well, this is the great part. We're going to do an exercise.
Fantastic. Wonderful.
Yeah. So tell me, again, I know I've done it before, but refresh me.
Sure.
Okay, so you want...
Sure. So spiritual exercise we're going to do, we're just going to try a mini one. This is, we're going to chant Hue.
Okay.
We're going to do it three times. And as we mentioned, anyone from any denomination can go to Royal Oak Mondays at 7 o'clock p.m.
Okay.
Or Ann Arbor. What time is the Ann Arbor one?
In Ann Arbor, we do a Hue chant on Friday nights at 6:30 at Crazy Wisdom.
Okay.
So what we'll do is we'll just practice right here, kind of show what it is. It's kind of similar to if anyone has tried but we just chant Hue.
Eyes open, closed.
Nope. So we just sit back, relax, eyes closed, focus on our spiritual eye, and just we'll sing Hue three times.
Okay.
And then when we're finished, I'll say, may the blessings be, and we can come out of it, and we'll feel the difference.
All right.
So just sit back and relax. Hue. May the blessings be.
Wow. One thing I can tell you is that you guys have some great lungs on you, because I could not hold that Hue.
So a little bit of practice, right?
I'm telling you, I better practice. I better practice, because I couldn't go the distance.
But it doesn't matter. You can do short Hues or long Hues.
Yeah. But you still feel the calmness of it. Thank you so much. It's always a pleasure to sit down with anyone from your group, from Ekankar. It's just delightful and informative and totally peaceful.
Well, thank you, and we greatly appreciate you having us.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Well, that's going to do it for us here at Reaching Out. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.